Welcome to How to Build a File Server in a Small Organization. I use a server with two network interfaces and three hard drives. One solid-state drive running the operating system, two traditional hard drives for file storage. I use two storage hard drives to protect data in case one of them fails. The operating system used is Windows Server and can be applied to most versions of Windows Server operating systems. With two network interfaces, I configure NIC teaming. You can use them to optimize bandwidth or redundancy of connections. In this case, I configure redundancy. If one of the two connections from the server to the switch fails, clients can still connect to the server. I set up a static IP address for the server. The server's IP address is 192.168.0.254. You restart the server to apply the changes. On the server, I install some more packages. With the above packages, I will turn the server into a domain controller and a file server. To manage resources more easily, I install the file server resource manager. Upgrading the server to a domain controller requires domain configuration. You set up the domain that matches your organization. Set up a recovery password. Then follow the steps above to complete the setup. The server will automatically restart and join the domain. My server has been upgraded to a domain controller. Set up DNS. You set up the DNS address. I set the DNS address to be the IP address of the server. Next, you set up DNS as above for the server. The purpose is to map between the IP address and the host name. Use the command prompt to register and check the results. That's it, the DNS has been set up successfully. To divide resources among people in the organization, divide them into hosts, groups, and users. Each row has multiple groups. Each group has multiple people. In this example, I add a new row called New York. Next, I create a new group called IT. The IT group has a member named John. Members of a group can only access files in their group. Storage configuration. With two hard drives, I configured storage as follows. You can configure more hard drives if you want. With more hard drives, you get more storage and are more fault tolerant and resource efficient. I create a new volume. I create a new virtual hard drive. The virtual hard drive uses two-way mirroring to protect data. That's how files are protected when a hard drive fails. As you can see, with two traditional hard drives, I only have one new partition. Next, I set up sharing of the server's storage resources for groups and their members. On the newly created partition, I added a new folder named IT. This folder stores files for the group named IT. You set up security on this folder. Only members of the IT group have access to files in the folder named IT. Members of other groups cannot access it. Members of the IT group not only have access but also have the right to add, edit, and delete files. In this case, John has access to files in the folder named IT. Not only that, he can add, edit, and delete files in that folder. This protects the privacy of groups within the same company or organization. In addition, it also makes data management easier. Next, I will introduce an advantage when deploying a domain. The IT folder will automatically map to the computers of members of the IT group. You do not need to create a network drive map on the client side. To do that, you create a new group policy as above. User configuration. Windows settings. Drive maps. New. Next, you set the path, choose the letter for the drive. Reconnect. You update the settings with the above command. It is not good if a group uses a lot of server resources. You should limit the storage capacity of each group. In this case, I limit the maximum capacity of the IT group to 100 gigabytes. Media files are always very large and quickly take up resources. I will prevent them from uploading multimedia files such as audio and video. To monitor resource usage, you should create reports. I create a new resource usage report for the group named IT. They are automatically generated twice a week. One more thing to note is the DNS configuration. You configure the forwarding as follows to ensure that the clients have an internet connection. Done. Let's check the results on the client. I have completed the basic steps to build a file server for a small organization. From here, you can build a server with more hard drives, serving more. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. As you can see on the client, there is a network hard drive.